हेलो डियर ऑल, दिस इज सदानंद मलिक वेलकम्स यू ऑल इन एंटायर फिजिक्स एंड टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द डिफ्रैक्शन ऑफ लाइट। एक्चुअली द जनरल मीनिंग ऑफ डिफ्रैक्शन इज द बेंडिंग ऑफ लाइट। डिफ्रैक्शन रिफर्स द बेंडिंग ऑफ लाइट at a sharp edge. Sharp edge means, for example, sharp edge means the sharp edge of blade, a razor blade, suppose. Razor blade is an example of sharp edge. So actually the diffraction of light is nothing but it means the bending of light at a sharp edge, means when a rectilinear propagating light incident on a sharp edge, then a few part of light gets deviated from its straight path and reaches at some other point on the screen if we placed it in front of the sharp edge. Then this phenomena is known as diffraction of light. Now let's see which type of occurrence will be there due to the bending of light or due to the diffraction of light. So let us consider here a sharp edge and an incident monochromatic beam of light. So suppose this is a sharp edge Now let us find the diffraction. So suppose on this sharp edge a straight light beam of monochromatic light is made incident, suppose like this. Suppose this is a incident monochromatic light source having the wavelength lambda. Then what will happen? Actually part of light will move without any deviation, but a few part of light gets deviated from its rectilinear path like this. And on the screen if we study, suppose then on the screen we will find that suppose this is the geometrical shadow part, then at the geometrical shadow part there is the presence of light up to some distance. There is a presence of light, means here suppose this is the screen, then when a monochromatic light beam is made incident on a sharp edge, most of the light will move without any deviation in this direction and reaches at the center point O. But due to the striking at the sharp edge, a few part of light gets deviated in this direction and reaches at a point P, suppose on the screen, means there is a presence of light in the geometrical shadow part of the screen. This phenomena is known as diffraction of light. And now this is the angle of diffraction. This angle theta is known as the angle of diffraction. Now let's see which type of occurrence and which type of intensity distribution will be on the screen. So let us draw the screen here again. So suppose this is the screen, means we are going to study the intensity distribution. So suppose this is the screen, and along this screen let us consider the distance. Suppose this is the central point O of the screen, and along the perpendicular direction of this screen let us consider the intensity axis. So suppose this is the intensity of light, then let's see which type of occurrence will be there. So actually what happened, what is going on here? So now when this light is made incident on the sharp edge, then due to the diffraction a few part of light will be reached at the geometrical shadow part, means at after point O in the downward direction. After point O the intensity of light is not become suddenly zero, but at point O there is some intensity of light. Suppose this is the intensity of light at point O. Suppose this is the intensity of light at point O, and this intensity reduces rapidly from point O to point P. Means suppose this is point P, and up to where there is some intensity of light. And in the illuminated part, what will be going on here? Actually, this intensity of light becomes zero after point P. Means here the intensity increases, and at a particular point it becomes maximum. Then again decreases, become minimum. Then again increases, become maximum, and then minimum, and then maximum, and then minimum. By this way, the diffraction will occur. Now let's see which type of occurrence will be there. So here the intensity will be by this way, and after some time the intensity will become continuous. So here this type of pattern will be found on the screen, means in the illuminated part. Suppose this is the illuminated part. And in the illuminated part, the intensity of light changes alternately. Means here, the intensity is maximum. Suppose this is intensity I naught. Then intensity is minimum. Means here, the intensity will become minimum. And again, intensity will become maximum. Again, intensity will become minimum. Again, intensity will become maximum. And then minimum. So by this way, we will find alternate change in the intensity of light. Now let's draw again this figure to further study and to study some important phenomena, some very interesting, amazing concepts. So suppose this is the screen, and this is the central point O. Suppose along this direction, let us consider the intensity of light I. And along this direction, this is the away from the central point. Now again considering another line to study the change in intensity in the illuminated part. So here there is some intensity. Now let's see here. Actually, suppose this is the point P, at where, up to where there is some intensity of light in the shadow part. So suppose this is shadow part. And this is illuminated part. Of the screen. Means below the point O there is shadow part, and above the point O there is illuminated part. Illuminated part and shadow part. Now let's actually, we have seen in the above figure that up to point P there is some intensity of light. Means here after the point P the intensity will become zero. But here from point P the intensity increases, and at point O the intensity will become, suppose this is the IM, minimum intensity. Now this intensity increases continuously and will become maximum here. Suppose this is the maximum intensity point, suppose I naught. And then as we move away from the point O in the illuminated part, then what will be found? Here the intensity goes to decrease and will become minimum. And here the intensity is, suppose minimum intensity is, suppose I dash. Now again, sorry, I one, suppose again the intensity goes to increase and will become maximum, and then decrease, then increase, and then decrease, and after some time it will become constant. Means here if we study, then we will find that the intensity in the illuminated part, the intensity first become maximum, then minimum, then again maximum, and then again minimum, then maximum, then minimum, and after a sufficient distance from the central point O, there will be uniform illumination like this. So here if we find, then we will find that suppose this is the bright fringe, this is the dark fringe, again this is bright fringe, again this is dark fringe, then bright fringe, then dark fringe, and after a sufficient distance there is uniform illumination. Uniform illumination. So here we will study that on the bright fringes, in the illuminated part, on the bright fringes the intensity goes to decrease continuously. In the illuminated part, the intensity of light goes to decrease continuously, we can see. And in the dark fringes, the intensity goes to increase continuously by this way. And after a sufficient distance from the central point, both the intensity will become equal. And here equal illumination we will find. And also in the shadow part, there is some intensity of light. So here we can define the diffraction as, when a monochromatic beam of light is made incident on a sharp edge, then on the screen which is kept in front of the sharp edge, there is some intensity of light in the shadow part up to a particular distance, and in the illuminated part there is the alternate change in the intensity of light. This phenomena of light is known as diffraction of light. So by this way we can define the diffraction. So obviously, if we study, then suppose this is the bright, then after bright we will find dark, then we will find bright, then we will find dark, then we will find bright, then we will find dark, and thereafter we will find the uniform illumination. So here, near the central point means near the central point or near the boundary of shadow part and illuminated part, near the boundary of shadow part and illuminated part, we will find the alternate bright, dark, bright, dark, bright, dark fringes. These phenomena are known as diffraction of light, and these fringes are known as diffraction fringes. So here we will study that, or we can say that on the diffraction of light, the intensity of all the bright fringes are not equal. Look here, the intensity of first bright fringe is maximum, then the intensity of second bright fringe will become slightly less than the previous one, and then again the intensity will become more minimum. Okay, means here we can say that all the bright fringes are not equally intense, but the intensity of the bright fringes decreases as we move away from the central point in the illuminated part. Similarly, also the dark fringes are not completely dark. Means here, suppose this is the first dark fringe, but it has some intensity. Look here, this is the intensity. And also, means all the dark fringes are not completely dark, but having some intensity of light. Just as we move away from the central point, the intensity on the dark fringes goes to increase. From this figure, it is clear that. So here, this is the complete explanation of diffraction of light.